Hello everyone, sorry if you joined in the previous stream. I was struggling with my microphone. As usual, there's always something that will go wrong. So yeah, there's always something that will always try and how can I say, mess you around a little bit and get all up in there. So I'm very sorry for starting a stream and then ending it so fast. But I'm pretty sure this one's gonna be the one. For everyone who's tuning in, I've decided to start a new map. Okay, I've gotten quite a little bit of bored with the previous Dunalka map, and I wasn't feeling it anymore. So instead, we are on a new map that's launched in the beginning of the year, if I'm not mistaken, somewhere around February or something like that. I'm unsure of the exact date but this map launched. It is an Australian map. It is based on a real spot in Australia. It is the Southern Cross Station. I haven't played this map yet or a lot in the offline vibe of this. But what I can say is I've watched videos for this map, and to say the least, it's a very interesting map and beautiful at the same time. It looks insanely good. Let's quickly do a little bit of a map tour. I've changed a few things. It's not the standard. It's not the standard vehicles that you will be seeing in the map, and also not the same grain bins. I've already upgraded. As you can see, I've got $8,000 in the account, which is lovely. But we're gonna make the best of this. And being in an Australian environment, what better vehicle to have than a Toyota Land Cruiser, 4.5 liter. Very nice indeed. Okay, let's drive around on this map a little bit and see what's going on and what are we gonna do, what are we gonna achieve, and what are we gonna basically work to in the end of everything. So what I've got now is I'm using all the standard things of this map. I'm not gonna sell vehicles and buy brand new vehicles. I am gonna use what I've got. I've got a little Fiat tractor here. Fiat, what's this thing? 1300 DT. On this side, I've got no idea how to say this name, but it is the big one on the farm. And then where we started off, let's get back there. Where we started off, we have a John Deere medium sized tractor. Very good tractor in it. It's gonna be the most overall one on the farm. There we see it. So I've got a baler. I've bought the baler to use the baler for whatever we're gonna do with it. I've obviously gotten one with wrapping so that we can do silage bales and take it from there. New Holland harvester, plain old harvester, nothing big major on it. And then we've got, I think this is the seeder on this side. Let's quickly jump out and have a look at this. Yeah, this is the cedar, if I'm not mistaken. I don't have any crops available to me. Well, I've got crops in the field, but I don't have any seeds on the farm. I can't do planting from the word go. On our left, field one is the one of the fields that we own. I think it's got wheat in it. And field two is on that end, the furthest end. It's got canola on it. Like I said in the beginning, I'm using all the things that's been given to me through the map. So I've literally, only thing I've changed, I've sold the old vehicle, the map starts with, and I bought myself this Toyota. I've bought myself the baler and also mowing machines. And then I replaced the grain bin, because the grain bins require quite a bit of it's a hassle to use the grain bin that's on here. If you know how to use it, it's good. It's fun, it's fast, you can do it. So, yeah. I think that's about it. House on the furthest end of the field. Here's the house where we started off the episode. Here's our auger wagon, which we'll be using to haul our corn. And yeah, there's our sprayer, and right in front of us here is our little water pit. It's a very nice map. The best feature of this map, most probably, is I'm gonna go and show you guys the entrance to this farm. You need to basically, well, there's two ways to get into the farm, not just one, but this is the best one to take. You need to cross this little river, and that's the way into the farm. There's the farm at the back now, but this is your way into the farm, and not, it doesn't just stop there. Like I said, you need to drive through another farm, which is pretty, I absolutely love it. So it's definitely, you can definitely look into it to buy, to do a multiplayer on this map. You've got more than enough place to begin a second farm and so yeah, this is that's the best feature of this map for me, is driving this route into your farm. It's not too far away from the shops, the buying station. It's not too far away from that. I'll show you in the PTO in a few moments, and I'll show you what's going on there. But yeah, for now, I think I'm gonna get started. I'm definitely gonna use cosplay in this series that I'm busy with. Or started today. It's a new one, brand new one. I got a little bit over the previous, the previous map. So, yeah, let's get into this. Let's get into our harvester and start harvesting crops. Just lift this header. I'm gonna do straw stashing on the wheat, definitely, because I can make bales and I can then sell the bales. I am gonna definitely buy a auto load trailer. It just works better. I'm not gonna struggle with the forklifts and all those things, yeah. So I'm definitely just gonna use an auto load trailer. It's easier, to be honest. It is just easier. So yeah, that's the story. This label straw station is peace. I'm gonna set this guy off on his course in a second, so that he can start doing his work. Great job, yes please. Field work, first waypoint, open course generator. Multiple tools now, yes. Number of headlands, I usually go for two headlands. It's better. It makes your turning radius on the fields better, and yeah, it just works. I'm gonna decrease this to 5%. We're gonna go clockwise, yes. Smooth. Oh, smooth headlands corners. Centers up and down, yes, please. That's it. Generate course. Okay, now field one harvesting. I think that's just things that I've put up. So this is field one. So I'm just gonna go and change it. Delete entry. Yes, please. Okay, this is field one. So let's save this as field one. Create a folder, field one. Thank you very much. Save course as harvesting field one. Okay, perfect. That one is saved. Okay, let's get in here. Driver wages, I'm gonna decrease this. Auto repair, don't repair, threshold, fuel threshold, 5%. Okay. Okay, that all looks good. Show course, start stop only. Race too early, late. That should be it. Save game, save all the settings, and let's tell this Oki to get going. Here we go, and he's off. Let him do his thing, and he's already not doing his thing. Sorry, sir, you're going in the wrong direction. Would you please? Please go straight and not sideways from the beginning, Dean. Okay, here we go. That should leave him on his course. Let's get the big boy. Big boy on the go. I'm not gonna start up setting up auto drive on this map yet. I will be doing it sooner rather than later, but I'm pretty sure I'll do that when I'm not online, because that's just, it's a mess up. Unless you guys want to see it, I mean, I can really show you guys. But yeah, nonetheless, we are up and running. We are doing it. Well, up and running in the sense of we just started, but nonetheless up and running. Gonna head straight to the harvester, get him set to do his unloading things. This tractor is really slow. I wonder if that smaller one, the medium sized tractor, is a little bit faster. Let's check what's going on here. Check what's going on. There we go. Clear a little bit of a path. take a bite of my food. Nice, very nice. Oh no. Not sure if this little small John Deere tractor is gonna be able to even pull this grain cart around. Let's see. Maybe it's stronger than we think. There we go, get into that. Nice. I don't think he's gonna handle it too well where there's a little bit more load on this, but he's doing it nonetheless, so let's continue. Let us continue indeed. This guy going back so far back. Nice. Getting somewhere slowly. Is it not better to drive around with the truck? Hmm. That's an interesting question. This mammoth out of the field. Jeez, this tractor is so slow. Maybe we should upgrade this guy first. So this is not gonna work for me. I mean, sure, it's a nice tractor to begin with off the bat, but I'm pretty sure I can get a John Deere that's gonna be the equivalent of this. Let's get this guy close to the field. I think I'm gonna set up course play for this field. Ach, auto drive, not course play. Okay. Okay. I'm just gonna do a test run before I start anything. See if we've got enough space. Okay, sure looks like we've got enough space. Okay, so for those of you who's been struggling with this, the easiest way to do this is keeping it simple, okay? If you press the record button right here, you're gonna have a point, okay? So that's gonna be your first point. I'm already gonna set my point with this button here. Edit, no. Yeah, it is that one. So this one will be weight field one. Okay, so that's telling this guy in this tractor to wait on this field. He's not gonna move, he's gonna wait here. Okay. Hello, Leafy. Mi fiance. So after I've told him to wait on that field right over there, we're just gonna do the loop around. And that's what you are not supposed to do. As soon as you do that, your course is missed. So I'm just gonna backtrack a little bit here. Maybe start my turn earlier. So don't worry if you're on this stage. All you want to do is you want to delete your nearest waypoints, okay? It will go back a little bit, but now it's gonna jump to that one there. Okay, let's delete all of them. Alright, so now there's the new waypoint, and now I'm starting my turn. Let's lower this thing a bit. Okay, this is gonna be our second stop. If my mouse just wants to work. This is our second stop, which will be unload. Might need to move this a little bit forward, but for now, let's keep it as that. Okay, and then all you wanna do is basically let this thing unload himself. After it's unloaded, I'm just gonna drive forward a little bit. Right up to the next point, which should be now. Okay, so now you wanna take your mouse, you wanna click on that point, and click on that point to close it. So we know we've got on this side also points that's not lined up. All you want to do is click on that point, click on that point, it will follow the line. So now that's set up. Okay, from here, let's just change these settings a little bit around. I like to have the points above tractor. It is just better like this. You can see it a little bit better, to say the least. But yeah, let's go and unload a combine. You want to wait field one and unload field one. That's what your course should be set. It's gonna say now we don't have a harvester set to this, but now here's the lacquer part. Jump into your harvester. Doesn't matter what settings you use. It's usually a little bit better. I don't know if it makes any difference, to be honest with you. If you put it on this. No, I'm just going to leave it as this. This is the one I've been using. I'm not going to play around with it now. So, If you do that, it is set now. So, pre-call on 60. Corner speed 100%. Yes, okay. Why are you driving around like a madman? Oh no. This is not good. Why is this thing driving around like a madman? I wonder what happened there. It was probably because I set the course. I think it's because of that. So let's go again. Okay. So we want combine offload weight fueled one. Alright, cornering speed. Let's just decrease this a little bit. Pipe offset, that should be fine. All of it should be fine. Auto refill, auto repair. No. What else is there? Pretty cool. Active unloading, no. Auto drive routes 5 locate distance, yes. Wait, sorry. Driver wage to 50%. Okay, and I think that's it. So apply the settings. Now. Edit mode. It usually takes a while to figure itself out. It will do funny things, I can promise you that, until it finds its little bit of a rhythm, and then it will go smooth from there. And that is what you want to see. It stopped perfectly, well, not perfectly, but close enough. I can't remember if it's these ones that you set. To change it, I can't remember. Pipe offset, I think if you take this closer. This one. 5 meters. Yeah, nonetheless. It will go better now. What this allows me to do. This allows me now to do baling while everything is going on the field. So we need a tractor that's 130. This little boy will do. this little boy will do. It's more than powerful enough to handle this. Baylor. So there's no problem with that at all. It is just slow nonetheless, but that's fine. This little guy is more than capable enough to do these things. Perfect. There's something that's auto unload baling. Maybe it's not on these balers. It's fine. Nice, let's see how this guy's doing. He's doing good. Do some bailing. Oh no. yes, please. Two ways of doing the hills, and I'm wondering if the other way is not faster. If you just get a baler that can pop out everything and then afterwards do bale wrapping, if you can do bale wrapping. Obviously in this case I can't do bale wrapping because I don't have the correct crops. Well, I think you can only do bale wrapping with grass, if I'm not mistaken. But nonetheless, combine is going. I've got a second helper that's doing the grain cart, auger wagon. He's dumping all the stuff he's collecting from the harvester. He's dumping all of those things, and he's also taking it back to the truck that's standing next to the field. And then I'm doing baling afterwards, cleaning up the mess. Sure, it's faster to do baling. Just baling. What is the problem, sir, in the harvester? I think you're stuck against my bales. That's not good. Let's quickly help this guy out. Oh no, that's not what I wanted to do. There you go, sir. Still gonna be in your way though. Is it? Anybody know if you can make silage out of square bales? I'm not sure you can do that. I'm pretty sure you can't, to be honest. never seen it happen. I'm gonna have to move all these bales a little bit outwards as well. They are gonna be in the way of the harvester coming up and down. Yay, lift in. Teamwork on that side of the field. Nice. It's going good. I shouldn't be looking at them and look at the line where I'm going. Catching up to the harvester. The small small tractor and huge baler is a weapon of a combination. It is going good. It is going good. Thank you, thank you. Another bale, done. I wonder if that's... I think the combine will be able to turn around up there. Yes, there's no bale in sight near him. This is good. Bye bye Bale. Oh no. Check at these guys working together like a mean team. go. Very, very nice. It is lekker to be lekker. This guy out again. Oops. It's a pleasure, sir. Just wanna have a look at this guy quickly. I think this is his first unload at the truck, but I haven't set him up to... Let's see what he does. Working a treat. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. So I'm gonna save you now. Just give me a second, please. Excuse me, sir. Fiat to the rescue. Okay, out of the way. No. Yes. Get in. That's it. Oops. Just tell you just to go to your next point. Then I'm gonna need to check where's the best selling price, because I don't want to save any of this. We are in Feb. Nope, I'm saving this. The prices are gonna increase quite a bit in the next few months, so rather than selling crops now, save it and then sell it for better profit. Me have a little snack again. Still busy eating my dinner. It's very cold now. At least the unloading is quite fast. One. Nice. Let's get the truck back to the field. Get him wait for. The rest of the corn, no, wheat. Another bale in the way of the harvester. Let's quickly go help that guy. A bit of a problem. Yeah, There you go, sir. Catching up to them quite fast now.
Nice.
Caught up to the bales. Well, the harvester in this case, not the bales. Yeah, have a ladder snack again. They are gonna make they're gonna take all my money. If I don't stop them. Still taking my money. Must have something to do with this. Settings for auto drive, auto connect, start. Nice. Here we go. Oh no. Being attacked by ants. It's ant war in my room. Okay. Eustace, we have a problem. Full of ants. Sheesh. Okay. Take this bale out of the way for that little oaky. Not like that. That's better. Blocked by an object, really? The one that I thought you would not be in the way of. It's not nice. But it's fine. I'm gonna help him out quickly. Good. complete this field. Close to done. Not too far. Everything. Just check these, Okay. nie wat hy aangaan nie. Looks like my silo is full already. So what this means is I'm gonna need to go and sell this. Let's get to that spot. Unload this bad boy. Beautiful little town. Oh, this is the first time out of the yard for whoever is watching. Yeah, this is the town site. It's very nicely done, to be honest. There's productions in here, there's so many things that's going on here, but it's nice. I do like it. Some of that money back. Not mistaken, I think this is the second way into the farm. It's a little bit further around, but pretty sure. Yeah, this is the way into the farm. Second way into the farm. So I'm gonna drive next to the combine, let him unload directly into this. think there's about 2 laps left for the harvester. Two, maybe 3. When we're done with this one, then I'm gonna get cracking. Gonna get myself some nice little sleep. And then I'll see you guys on the next one, which shouldn't be too long from now. It's a hard knock life for us. Yeah, almost done with this field. Get excited. Struggling a bit to get done. It's taking way longer than I expected. But nonetheless, getting it done. Getting it done nonetheless. See if that combine's gonna make one last run up here. Pretty sure it is, but it's gonna get blocked by bales. At least we've knocked out not just one thing, but actually a few things on this field. Doing harvesting. Doing harvesting and doing baling at the same time. Not too bad. Let's just stop this guy. So what it looks like, he's gonna drive up here this side, turn around and do the last run down. I'm not sure if that's what's gonna happen. Let's see what he's up to. He's gonna get blocked by this. And, okay, so he's doing his last run. Nice. Let's get this truck out of the way. Finish baling. And then we can sell the little bit of crops that we've got in this in our truck over there. And then go park our implements. We'll call it a night. Next episode will go on field 12. Gonna do some harvesting on field 12 for the canola. Wait for the right time to sell all these things. I've run out of space already on my silo. Didn't buy a very big silo, to say the least. But it's okay, we will make it work. We are gonna make it work, definitely. Let's just have this guy again. Him do his last pass. And he's complete. Not too bad, not too bad at all. Strip there beautifully. I'm not even gonna do the last pass up. It's such drips and drabs. I don't know how to, well, it depends. If there's a little bit left to go, I might just do it. Complete that run up there and then maybe get our last bale out. Should work. Should work. Pretty sure with all these drips and drabs that's left on the field, I might be able to get this last bale out. Out on you. see if we can complete this last bale of all these pieces I've left. Don't think so, and I'm not gonna go past every single one just to try and complete one last bale. Yeah, no, I think I'm gonna leave it there. Let's quickly run around this way. Okay, quickly gonna get myself a nice screenshot. There we go. Okay. This one. Okay, there we go. Okay, let's take these guys back to the yard. Just take this one back. Okay, nice. And that's the beauty. Well then, I think I'm gonna call it a night. I've done quite a few productive things in this evening on the farm. You guys have yourselves a lovely evening. Catch you on the next one. Look out for episode 2 of this farm, where we will continue harvesting on field, I think it's 21, where the canola is growing. And yeah, have a good one. And thank you for watching.